Yes, that's what this is all about. Because of what is taking place today, there are circumstances going on with the corporation. And I will say this, that many of those people that have been in the corporation for a long time, for decades or what have you, as an example, you know, our good friend Val here, a lot of things have changed and people in their minds are thinking that, oh, gee, the corporation is the same, or they've heard ideas about Paul, as an example, that he plagiarized or he did this or that, or he had certain teachers and masters and what have you in the past. And yes, it's understandable. All of us have come through something. And some people I've read, they go back further than that. They go to his parents and his relatives. And Paul went through a lot of things when he was young. And all of us have. All of us have come up through a lot. I explained some of the things that I came up through, and I was basically raised with my mother. They had divorced when I was 1 year old. And, you know, that's really not the particulars. But, you know, there's a bigger picture. And that is what we're presenting, and that is we're showing people how to recognize their real awareness. And so this is what I focus on. Yes, we have our personal life here in the physical, and to most people, this personal life, this physical life is all there is. Most people are very one-dimensional, but they really do not realize that they have four other bodies, and they're actually living in other dimensions. And on top of that, they have a real awareness that supersedes all of it. And to get to that is huge. And so here we have many floating ideas over the centuries, and a lot of them are just, you know, very limited or a lot of deception and marketing ploy to herd people into what we call human farming. And that's what this planet is really all about. And most people are still not awake to that. And so that's our position as worldwide educators. So I'm going to go over kind of a brief history, and each person can decide for themselves. Things can be verified on the real side with the real guides, and this is actually what they are, real universal guides. Paul and the boys in his days created the idea of Ek Master idea. They just simply created that idea because that was for the times. And Paul, what he did is, when the plagiarism idea comes in with what Paul did, is you have to realize that he had several typewriters going, three or four at the same time, writing the books. Paul was like the newspaper man in those days, and, you know, he was pounding the keys. He didn't have a computer. He didn't have Word docs where he could correct things or whatever. I mean, he was pounding the keys, and he had to use whiteout. And so what Paul did also, you know, these are the compiled works of Paul. He put many things together. He used many things from other people also that were already written, because instead of him writing it all out there, because that was a lot of work, he just compiled these things, put it together, created the books, because he wanted to get the information out there, because it does take a lot to do that. And it's amazing what Paul did in those days. And it was kind of like an MLM. You know, it was word of mouth, because we didn't have the internet and things like that. And so eventually his presentation of Ekinkar took off. And it was to be a particular. In other words, this was really step one. He was creating the foundation. He used the God idea. He used the spiritual idea. He used these different ideas. This is really what they were at the time, because he didn't want to create something too much different from what the true reality is, the all is or the isness, because this is really too much for people to really comprehend. So as I came into the scene, I started with Paul because I had been in previous lifetimes with Rebazar and also Paul. We had prepared for this lifetime, and I write more about this in Book 9, which is out right now as we speak. I'll be sending it out so people will get an idea, and this is just the first part of Book 9, because as the years go by, there's going to be a lot added to it. There's been a whole interesting, you might say, conspiracy that's been going on since the day that Paul left. And so, like anything in the world here, any of the happenings, etc., like 9/11 or World War II or just anything, you don't hear about what's really taken place for years later, usually decades later, and then all of a sudden it starts to filter out. And we're in the information age, a super duper today. That's very real because we have the internet and we have all this access. We have Skype that we're on, we're recording this on, and all these things, which are great. Okay, the controlling systems of the world have set this up, and we're using their systems to get to people out there. So prior to this lifetime, as I came in, my last lifetime, which is Book 1 of the Adventurous series. There's basically 8 books, and that is called From Then Till Now. And that is my past life with Rebusaur and the boys, preparing for this lifetime here and then coming into this lifetime. And then it becomes book 2, which is A Journey to Real Freedom. I explain my coming into this life and growing up with my mother and the experiences that I was having and trying to share with her, but she wasn't interested. And eventually, Rebusaur was prompting me because Paul was setting up his position. He was to come first with what he is doing. And eventually, at a certain age, prompting me to get into his corporation, what he was doing with the outer works here. And I wasn't really interested at first because I'd left high school and I wasn't really interested in the literal side. I was a surfer and I just wanted to go out there and, you know, do whatever. And I was having these experiences with Rebusaur. But as I read Paul's first book, The Tiger's Fang, all of a sudden I decided, yes, I will step forward. I will step into this. And that was basically around 1970 at some time. I was kind of ready. And Paul, it's interesting, 1965, basically October 22nd, he took on the real Rod of Power and that he would be around for about 5 years. But he actually stayed longer for me because I was not quite ready. He actually stayed almost a year longer through September of 71 because there was a lot of things going on the real side that most people don't know about. And so I'm not going to go over all of this, but I will say that the ideas that people have about Paul, until they look at the real side, until they really understand a bigger picture than creation itself, they're only going to get ideas of who Paul was and the real guides are, the real universal guides. And they had created this Eckmaster position simply as a front because they knew it was fragile and it would only last so long. And as we're in to 2016 right now, and there right now is a lawsuit with the corporation because through these two individuals of Darwin Gross and Harold Klemp, and especially Joan Klemp, who is of a reptilian factor, has taken over the corporation. Well, people are still thinking the corporation is the same when it is actually not. It's not even close. These individuals were to be positioned in a particular way, but they became self-absorbed. And the boys basically knew this. And this really is part of a huge wake-up. I kind of look at it like Batman and the Joker, and you need the Joker as part of the adventure. And it's really a big adventure. That's how I see it. That's how I like it. As I've created the position here since 2001, when I took on the real Rod of Power with Rebusaur and Paul, they gave me the real Rod of Power in 2001. Then in 2007, became the New Wave Is. They wanted me to change the name and everything because so many people had taken Paul's works and started other paths and claiming they're having the Rod of Power. So everything began to change. And then the new you came out. The hue was no longer used and was no longer the real connection. Most people didn't pay attention to that. And the reptilians took over. And that's what it is today. It's all tap lining. We're in the new era of tap lining. And it's very, very real. And so I've written a lot on that. People want to look at that. They want to watch their dreams because almost everybody on the planet is being infected and turning reptilian. And it's not because I say so. It's because it is taking place. It's very, very real, like the chemtrails in the sky and the vaccines and the GMO food and the microwaves. We're in a whole different era, and it's very, very real. Fukushima is still on. It's been on for 6 years. You don't see it in the news, but that doesn't mean it's not taking place. That doesn't mean it's not through the whole Pacific Ocean, etc., and all over the world. And it's not good. And I've created the new presentation, Foundation. This basically implies Dwayne the Great Writer and the Adventurous series. And this is pretty heavy stuff for people, but it's very real and it's very wonderful. For those that just simply start to read the books, they will get a much better understanding. And as they sing the new you, they will get a better understanding of things. When Paul was here, Paul was the real guide. That was the essence. And he did many creative things to bring this out into the public. The public view, which is usually one-dimensional, they see things a certain way. That view usually gets distorted, and then rumors start, and it's this and that and whatever. And Paul really started off with basically astral projection, or what he called bilocation, and then he turned it into what he termed as soul travel. And when I was there in the beginning, It was called Ekankar, the Ancient Science of Soul Travel. That's what it was called. Then as Darwin came in, he started to change that around. He started to change the titles and all that stuff around. And Darwin became very self-absorbed. And he was given an opportunity. And I'm not going to say everything here, but as people read Book 9, they will get a better idea of what's really going on and how this adamant conspiracy really started in those days. But again, it's part of the adventure, and it's okay because there's an overall picture here, a bigger picture, and that is it's about a worldwide wake-up. And we are right in the middle of this, and this is where those people that are still in the corporation or so-called spiritual paths or whatever, and I don't refer to any of this because we're not religious, political, spiritual, transcendental, or any of these things. We're just very real and wonderful. We get our experiences from the real side and also our real awareness. We make sense of things. We're here for the all-natural environment on all levels, not only the physical, but through all of creation and into what I term as the real universes, and those have to be recognized. It's not necessarily that they are places in life, but it's a recognition to where you stand real in a real position, what I call universal positioning, which supersedes astral projection, remote viewing, soul travel, and all these things. And Paul started off there just so that people could get the experience. And his spiritual exercises were basically with the knowledge where you sit down, you do an exercise for 15 or 20 minutes, and you listen for the sound and you look for the light. And the light is basically the astral light, because when you're in creation, the real light comes through the different layers of creation and you get a reflective light. And this astral light is the knowledge. So you first need the knowledge to become more aware, to be able to eventually recognize the real light in the real universes. And the sound itself, that is the reality of the isness. But Paul started off with the God idea, and then later on he brought in the Sugmod idea. And so this was actually rather humorous. He was trying to offset the God idea. He was taking things a step at a time, because in the beginning it was the God idea. Now, the God idea was created by the reptilians as the first invaders here. They created all the religions and the sacrificial rites and all these things. And this has been going on for endless centuries here and other planets and systems. And again, in Book 9, I go over some of the yugas vaguely, giving people a better idea. But it's best that people get their own real side experiences. And while Darwin and while Harold were here as the so-called masters, they took the titles of Paul. They didn't have the awareness, but they took the title because they were showmen and became self-absorbed. They never had the awareness, and they really have misused a lot of people. This is where the tap lining comes in, but behind the curtain, behind the scenes, was the influence, and that's Crony Joni. And so this is what most people don't see. They see her as this sweet little master's wife. Well, that's fine. You can decide whatever you want. I'm not for nor against this. I like the adventure. I think it's cool what she's doing, but I don't support her. She's deciding, and everybody has the right to decide their life, their fate. The end result is everything in creation is cause and effect. And she is becoming the effect more so because she's played her role very, very well. And now it's time for all deception to show up. And it is. But there's always going to be the diehards there that are emotionally attached, just like people are to Jesus from 2,000 years ago, because they have this marketing idea of this individual that came here, gave some truths. But it's all in creation, and with the gods of man, this is what people don't see, and they don't see how controlled they are with the systems here and the authoritarians and the church and the Vatican and all these things. And again, this is not a put down or a criticism. We're not here to change anything. I've created a position with a new presentation, and then I've created the WWE, which is Wonderful Worldwide Educators. We are here to show people how to stand real with, actually, the all-natural environment that supports us all. And the true reality of life is the all is, beyond creation itself. And it's like the sun shining. There are no restrictions. There are no do's and don'ts. The individual decides what their life is to be, and to recognize this reality and to make better choices with everything that they do, and it becomes a lot more fun. I've made it fun, and it is. Well, this is where, for the most part, because I don't use the old ideas of God's spiritual soul, teachings, and all these things, that people, for the most part, and those that I've known especially, do not recognize what I'm doing because there is a bigger picture altogether, and this was all planned by the real guides long before the earth was even here. And so the new you is actually from the heart of life, and the words like Om, Amen, and Hu, and all these things, and even Paul used those. Again, it was the start, like the God idea. They had their day. The days of masters and gurus are gone. They had their day, just like many things that we've seen in this lifetime, like the Model T Ford and whatever else you have here. Things have come and gone, like the hula hoop and whatever. They're gone. And people still do use them. But, you know, there's a bigger picture, and that is what we're presenting, and that is we're showing people how to recognize their real awareness more so than just the love idea, their personal life, etc. These are things that, you know, people can decide for themselves. They decide their personal life, but there is a bigger picture. And eventually, you do not have to return here once you have the awareness to recognize the real universes. But at the same time, while you're here, I see the benefit of trying to do something beneficial for this world by the very fact that I've created the projects as I have. And Paul did start some stuff. He started a product, an MLM called Sunisu. His wife became president and she became very well-to-do because of that. And Paul created that. It was a vitamin mineral supplement with Dr. Bernard Jensen. And I had met Dr. Bernard Jensen up in LA when he was here, when I was younger, with my wife. I got a little involved in it, but I was in my construction business, became a general contractor. And so I liked that business, so I was fine. And so I dabbled in some of these things, some of the MLMs, and it was fun. And we'll probably be doing many businesses like that with the New Presentation Foundation and especially worldwide educators. And so I created this second position simply to have a better reference for the public to better understand what we're doing and to have fun with this. Yes, and just to make it fun, like the sun shining. And that's what we are. We are the sun shining and no restrictions. In Paul's days, in 1990, I was a seventh initiate. That's when the initiations were real because the boys were standing with me. And actually, Rebazar was giving me the initiations up until 2001, up into the 14th circle on the real side, and not here because everything had been curtailed here. Everything had stopped. Harold decided no. He was controlling things with Joni, etc. And that's fine. You can't stop life itself. So it was all happening on the real side. And at the time, my friend Heather, she was seeing this too. Other people were, but they're no longer around. It doesn't matter. I'm not here to prove anything. I'm just here to do the adventure and do what I do. I love what I do. And I love this adventure. I love the challenge. And I love being creative with it. And I'm very appreciative of those people that have the courage to step up and be themselves, like Val and many, many others that I would like to mention. These people will be known in the world because they're very real, they're very sincere, they're very aware. I feel it to be a privilege to know them and that they recognize what I'm presenting, and especially the real guides, because they stand real with me, and the whole of life does also. And again, things will only work here according to the whole of life and the real guides. That's the real essence of things. And without that, there is nothing. It's like a hollow building with nothing in it. And this is where eventually what Paul created became very, very hollow. And so we have people stepping up now that had been in the corporation since those days, and they see the difference. And they see that there was nothing there. It almost happened immediately because, again, in Book 9, I explain this why, and people will get a better understanding. And this will be confirmed once they learn to go to Rebazar Tars and Paul Twitchell on the real side. So no matter what is said about Paul in the physical sense, go to the real side and find out for yourself, because he's there with the real guides and the real universes. And again, in this world of distortion, anything can take place. We have governments here that set people up to take the fall, and then there's takeovers here, etc., all the time by the different governments of the world. There's so much deception going on, and I'm not going to go over this in this video here, but people can research this for themselves. And so many things are coming out. I suggest people study the monetary system. Look at, you know, many different things on YouTube from David Icke, David Wilcox, and there's just many, many things out there. The belief systems, the religious, the educational system, etc. These are controlling factors. And yes, as people learn to survive and have to sustain themselves here, they will use these systems. And we use the systems. We're not negating the systems. Nothing is negated. We don't negate anything. We're very creative. It's like a block of clay. You can make it into anything you want. And I see that. And the world is a challenge. I take that on. But at the same time, I'm going to be constantly presenting something real and that makes sense. And most people want to hide out and pretend things aren't happening, like the chemtrails and the vaccines and the GMO food and microwaves, mind-controlling microwaves and HARP, just everything that's taking place. And there's so much more that has taken place on this human farm planet. And it's being purposely poisoned. And the children, we see this as the future. And the future is coming very fast. And it's not getting better here. It's getting worse all the time. So I'm not predicting doom. It's just that the overall created consciousness of people is unconsciously agreeing to what has taken place, and they do not see that. They see the surface world of what they want to decide, but unconsciously they're agreeing to the demise of the planet, and they do not see this. And so I suggest to learn about the astral causal mental etheric bodies that you have, and eventually your real awareness. And if you start to read the Adventurous series, the 8 books, they're available. People can download them for free. We are all over Facebook. Contact Eva, Duane, and Ava on Facebook, etc. We'll send you a free book. I suggest to read the books and eventually book 9 and learn to get your own real side experiences, what the true reality life is, the all is, starting off in your dream visions. And life will show you, instead of deciding what life is, learn to let life show you. And that's the biggie. So standing beside your literal self and not just framing this idea of what you think life is, but let life show you, learn to become a little more humble and let it show you what it really is. And it's like the sun shining. It's that real silent language. You learn to recognize that and what's taking place, and that becomes your real awareness. And then eventually you do see and recognize and perceive how you're operating these different 5 bodies. And it's just not a physical body where you become the effect of everything, because you are here. You're in cause and effect. And if you just stay one-dimensional with the physical body only, you will simply grow old, as you have many lifetimes before. And you will forget that you are here, and that's coming up. So you want to prepare yourself. That's your choice. Each person makes the choice. And I like the adventure myself, and the real guides are there. They provide real guidance and a real education like no one else, and that's what we're doing as worldwide educators, as wonderful worldwide educators. And we have Skype groups all over the world. People are welcome to step up and take part in this. And so simply, again, or look on the internet, Duane the Great Writer. I'm all over Google. You can Google me. There's pages and pages that come up. That's D-U-A-N-E, the Great Writer, Duane the Great Writer. We're here for you. This is our adventure. Step up, become more aware with us, because it's endless. There is no end. And learn to free yourself from cause and effect creation. So that's a little overview of the idea here from Paul's day to the new wave is now, the new man. And so there's a lot in between. Little by little, people can learn about the real history of what's going on here, more so than just the marketing ploy of some corporation giving out fake initiations, creating deception and taplining others. So, yeah, there is a much bigger picture here. It's all for you. You decide to step up or not. So have fun. Thank you for listening.